It's been revealed that Prince William settled a phone hacking claim against Rupert Murdoch's media empire for a very large sum following a secret agreement. Let's bring in Daily Telegraph Associate Editor Camilla Tominey in London. Camilla, thanks so much for your time. Now, this is pretty big. I mean, it happened in 2020, but court documents have only just revealed it.
Yeah, it's another bombshell from Prince Harry, really, Sarah, in the sense that the royals were completely blindsided by this very lengthy statement in which he goes into great detail about why he's making this claim against, this time it's the News Group UK. So he's been suing Associated Newspapers, which are the publishers of The Mail and Mail on Sunday. This is suing the publishers of The Sun and Sun on Sunday for hacking. And effectively what he's saying, or what he's at least implying in this statement, which I think has certainly ruffled feathers behind palace gates, is that, you know, that he's been the one on this kind of one-man quest to protect royal privacy while making, by implication, aspersions on his brother for settling this case in 2020 for, as you say, this very large sum. But the thing is, what happened by Harry's own admission is that both brothers were united and using the same legal firm to try and pursue this compensation for hacking. And then in 2019, Harry, by his own admission, went off with his own solicitor and decided to do his own thing. He decided to take the case all the way to trial. Clearly, William was advised to do something completely different and did settle. But Harry seems to be very put out by this, because the case on behalf of the newspapers is that he's left it too late to bring this action, and they're trying to have it struck off.
Well, I guess everything, as with every Harry story, it's so public, right? And William, as you say, prefers to go the other way. But in this case, we know that Harry's lawyer is the one who revealed it in court. I guess hoping that it will help Harry's case. Do you think it will?
Well, it might do. I mean, I think the judge is obviously trying to balance the weight of Harry and other claimants' state of loss with regard to what they suffered as a result of intrusion by the media. But at the same time, I think there's a legitimate criticism of Harry that he perhaps didn't need to go into quite so much detail in a witness statement. It's always going to be lodged in public and therefore be covered by privilege, even if it seemed defamatory and plain for all to see. I think the royals would be scratching their heads saying, you know, what more is yet to come? The coronation is fast approaching. It's 11 days away. They've got to be reunited for the first time since Spare has been published. And now another grenade in the form of this witness statement has been dropped on the proceedings.
It is interesting, as you say, certainly the timing of it, but what do you think is the end game here for Prince Harry? I mean, is it the money that he's after? Obviously, we don't know the sum that was paid to William, but is it the money that he's after, or is it really just more headlines and making a point here against the media?
Well, he'll obviously rebut any suggestion that he's generating headlines and feeding the frenzy, or causing the feeding frenzy in the first place. But of course, all of this will now make headlines around the world. That's why we're discussing it here today. I think the end game for Harry, by what he's saying in the witness statement, is he wants to take on and change the press. He wants to fundamentally overhaul the way that the media operates. But then his relationship with the press, it's been similar to his brother's. Both of them have had very difficult relationships over the years, and neither of them have forgotten or forgiven the press and the paparazzi for hounding their late mother, Diana. But at the same time, I think William's approach is, look, the media and the monarchy need to work together because they need each other, whereas Harry seems to be much more combative in his approach and wanting to change things from within.
Oh, we'll see how this one plays out. Camilla, as always, thanks for your insight. Court documents have revealed Rupert Murdoch's media business secretly paid Prince William a very large sum of money to quietly settle a phone hacking claim. Europe correspondent Carrie-Anne Breenbank has more for us. Good morning, Carrie. It's quite the revelation.
Good morning, Sarah. Well, this is the first time the public's heard of this. So court documents in Prince Harry's lawsuit against The Sun and the now-defunct News of the World are claiming that Rupert Murdoch's newspaper group paid a quiet settlement to Prince William in 2020 over phone hacking allegations. The documents claim Prince William was paid a very large sum, but don't say exactly what that is or specifically what it was for. But Prince Harry's lawyers are also claiming that there was a secret deal done between Buckingham Palace and the newspaper group so that members of the royal family didn't bring any further lawsuits until other, older phone hacking lawsuits had been finalised. That's something that the newspaper group is denying, that there was ever such a deal. But Prince Harry wasn't in court today. He was spotted watching the basketball with wife Meghan in LA. But the High Court hearing runs for 3 days, and this case is one of a number of legal battles that Prince Harry is currently fighting against British tabloids, all of them alleging illegal information gathering. Sarah?